Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to be taking a look at something a little bit different. Usually I look at camera equipment, but as well as doing camera, I also edit quite a lot, and I've been editing for a number of years. And so today I'm looking at a product that specifically I would use for editing and color grading. Now this product can be used for a number of different things, but those are the features and programs I'm going to be looking at today. And the product is this. Now it's the TourBox Elite Plus. Now like I said, you can use this in a bunch of different applications, from video editing, digital printing, but I'm mainly going to be looking at how it performs in video editing and color grading. Now TourBox make a bunch of these, it's not just one. I'm looking at the Elite Plus, but they make a range of them that have different layouts in the buttons and stuff like that, and they range in prices as well. So I've been video editing for well over 10 years now professionally. And one of the things I love most about video editing is how each project differs. You could be working on a multicam edit, a sit-down interview, a short film, a music video, a feature film. There's so many different projects and they just range in how you tackle them. Now, one of the things that I think makes me a good editor is efficiency. And that's the ability to carry out all the tasks you're doing on a daily basis quickly. You know, from switching from the select tool to the cut tool, stuff like that. You want to be able to do all of these things quickly, scrubbing the timeline, zooming in, zooming out, knowing where everything is. Efficiency is key, and that's where the TourBox comes in. It's designed to give functionality and control in a small space. So instead of that being spread out across your entire keyboard, what they're doing is they're taking all the functionality that you might need and packing it into one little box. So you've got everything from toggling the timeline, to zooming in, to selecting tools, to saving, stuff like that. Now I know what you're thinking, maybe that's only gonna save you a second here or there, but spread out over an entire project, it's gonna save you more and more time. And time is money, because the quicker you get something done, the more efficient you are, the more time you have to do other work. Now one thing that I really like about the TourBox is it's really easy to use, it's really easy to set up. It connects via Bluetooth, so there's no cables, and it's just some batteries in the back that you can swap out. So you basically download the application, connect via Bluetooth, and you're ready to go. But one other thing that I love about this is that it has presets built in. When you select your application, it's gonna just basically go to the preset that it has installed for that application. Also, there's user-generated presets. I feel like I'm saying presets a million times, but yeah, user-generated. So if you don't like the one that it auto-selects for you, you can build your own, you can pick someone else's, you can customize someone else's, you can customize the one that's set in. So I love that functionality. I love that you can customize this to the way that you work, and you're not just limited to what it presets for you. You know, I've used grading panels in the past, and yes, you can customize those, but it's not as easy to do. This is really easy to use. It's a really user-friendly application. It makes setting your own presets really simple. And so when I install the application and I set this up, I noticed that there are a couple of buttons that they just leave blank for you to set to whatever you want. So one thing I like to do, for instance, is just have a really easy way to save it. You never know when your application's gonna crash. That happens as an editor. We've all lost work. Autosave can save you sometimes, but yeah. We've all been there. We've all not saved and lost like 30 minutes, an hour. So one thing I like to do is get in the habit of just clicking save. So I set up a button on this, tap that button, I know it's saved, and that's really handy, it's right there. So why would you choose to use this over just a keyboard? Now, if like me, you've been editing for a long time, you're probably pretty efficient with that keyboard, you know where the shortcuts are. You can get the overlays that tell you where the shortcuts are, but a lot of the time I'm not looking at the keyboard anyway, so, you know, looking to see where that preset is on a diagram that's on the keyboard is probably a lot slower than. I've set up some shortcuts on my mouse as well, so if I toggle some buttons on my mouse, I can go between the select tool and the cut tool, and that saves me time, because I know that I'm going to be using those functions quite quickly. So why would I need something like the TourBox? So the TourBox isn't just buttons. It's got dials and scrolls. So if you're doing something like scrolling through a timeline, this is going to make that a more efficient, because you can just scrub the dial as opposed to using your mouse to scroll. Again, zooming in and out, instead of clicking plus minus to get in and out, you can just toggle that dial, and it's going to make that a lot easier because that's all on your hand. You're not having to go over here to do it, then back to there. It's all designed to just keep your hand in one place, one hand on the mouse, one hand on the TourBox. Now, one other thing as well is that going between applications. Now, one of the things that the Adobe Suite, for instance, kind of prides itself on is you've got multiple different applications that you use. And as an editor, I use a lot of those applications. So I might switch into Photoshop, switching between programs, After Effects, you know, all of this kind of works together. And what's great is as I switch between these applications, the TourBox will work natively with a lot of these applications, meaning that rather than learning all the different shortcuts for all the different applications, you can have all of this functionality built into this one unit. Now, one other thing that kind of comes naturally with editing is color grading. Quite often, I am going from the edit to the color grade. Now, I do a lot of my grading in DaVinci, because it's just, in my opinion, much better. If it's simple grading, I'll probably stay in Adobe, but if the client has paid for a color grade specifically, then I'm going into DaVinci and I'm gonna be grading in that program. Now, I've had panels before that work in DaVinci. I've had the ripple, stuff like that. That only works really in DaVinci for color grading. It doesn't work for editing. You know, you're not really gonna get a lot of functionality out of that panel for those other programs. One of the things that I love about this is I can go natively from an edit program to a color grading program, and I'm still getting all of those shortcuts for each program, and it works natively in this application. Now, the developers made tons of plugins for different editing programs, features like Tour Menu, where you can have custom color grading panels for programs like Premiere Pro and macro tools for stuff like DaVinci. Now, one other thing I want to highlight is the hover adjust feature that works in DaVinci. Now, it's currently in beta, but it is going to be rolling out. And what it does is when you hover your mouse over any slider, color wheel, curve or value field in the color panel, a highlight will appear. And now you can instantly control it using the TourBox dials and wheels. Now, as a pro editor, what can the TourBox do for you? Like I said, you're probably at this point, you're pretty efficient already. Now, I do want to be honest, using something like this, it's going to be a learning curve. You're going to have to get used to where stuff is, and that does take time. It's not immediate. But one thing that I did find really intuitive and I just kind of took to naturally instantly was the grading in Premiere Pro. When you go to the grading section, you get this overlay that comes up and it has all of your settings, whether you're in the basic, creative, whatever. It's got different panels that come up depending which of those menus you're in. And what you can do is that will overlay the footage. It will appear wherever you want to position it on the screen. And you can use the dials, the buttons to just navigate that and tweak it. And it's way easier and simpler than using the dial with the mouse and just clicking and dragging. You can tweak the dial. It's going to do it in various increments. And then you can press the button to just go down. And what that allowed me to do is rather than looking where the mouse pointer was and selecting different things, I could keep my eyes on the image. And I could see that panel just off to the side and I could just tweak things. So it just meant that I was constantly looking at the image that I was grading as opposed to looking at what I was doing. And I really liked that and I took to that immediately. So is this going to replace your keyboard? I don't think that's the point, to be honest. Like, one of the things that I really like about this is how small it is. It easily sits on my desktop next to my keyboard and I can keep it there. With the grading panels that I've used in the past, you know, that's sitting in front of me, my keyboard's moving to the top, to the side, wherever. When I'm using the TourBox, I don't need to do that. It's so small and portable, so if I want to take it with me, if I'm working, you know, out of my office and I'm going on location, I could easily take this with me. And it's only going to take up a little amount of room in my laptop bag. So yeah, I don't think for me it's going to replace my keyboard. I've got my TourBox, my keyboard and my mouse side by side. And maybe I'm going back to my keyboard for certain things and then I'm going to the TourBox when I'm using it for certain applications. I've been looking at a lot of the options out there and I've never taken the plunge. I'm really lucky that TourBox reached out and asked me if I wanted to review this because immediately I knew who these guys were because I've been following them and I definitely wanted to review it because I'd been considering buying one anyway. Is this something that's going to replace the keyboard? No. But then you're using your keyboard for all the other different stuff. You know, as an editor, you'll be editing, maybe you'll get an email. You want to jump back to answer the email. So it's really nice that I've still got my keyboard there, my mouse there. My computer can be used as is. I'm not having to move things out of the way. And then I've got my TourBox there that my hand just instinctively can go to. And I'm getting the functionality that that brings on top of being able to use my computer as a computer. So now let's talk about price. Now, the TourBox Elite Plus is currently on sale for about £213. What do I think of that price point? Is that reasonable? So the previous device that I had that I used for color grading was the Ripple. Now that retails for about £300. If you look at the DaVinci panels specifically, they get quite expensive. You could go for something like the DaVinci Edit keyboard, but then that only works in DaVinci. That's only going to give you the functionality in that program. And that's roughly, I think it's a little bit more expensive of this. So is this a reasonable price for what they're giving you? Well, this is the highest end version of the TourBox, the Elite Plus. So there are cheaper options if you don't want to go for the Elite Plus, if you don't need the functionality that that brings. But yeah, I do feel like this price is reasonable, because if you look at the competitors for similar things, they're more expensive. Now, like I said, one of the great things about this is you're getting the functionality across many different apps. You're not just tied down to one app. And I love that because I use a lot of applications. A lot of people, I'd imagine, use a lot of applications. And then also one of the things that I really love is that you can just download other people's presets. There's a whole network out there of presets that people have made for various applications. That's going to come in really handy, because it's going to stop you having to program every single button if you don't want to do that. If you just want to get a quick preset that someone's made, install it, and away you go in whatever program you're using. So yeah, I'm a big fan of this. I'm going to be using it in my workflow. I'll be taking it with me if I'm going out on location, because it's so handy and it just fits in my laptop bag. So that about wraps it up, guys. What are you using in your edit workflow? I'd really love to see, especially desk setups. I love desk setups. I don't know about you, but having like a tidy desk for me is key for editing. Like, editing is organizing a lot of the time. So having everything organized is a big thing for me. So I would love to know what you guys are using for your, you know, using anything, just using a keyboard. What are you using for grading, editing, photo editing? Do you have any panels like this? Are you considering this? What is it that you like about it? What is it that you don't like about it? I'd love to get a discussion going in the comments and answer any questions that you have on this. So thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you next time.